Hi, with this video I will show you how to properly pressure test residential pool and spa plumbing pipes in order to verify if a line has a leak. I will also show you what mistakes to avoid, and I will give you some tips and tricks that will make the pressure test process really easy. I put in many hours of work and I promise to give you the most detailed pressure test video on pool and spa plumbing lines. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Chris Elias and I'm the owner of Pool Leak Detection LLC. On this channel, I'm trying to give you as much valuable information on pool leak detection as possible so it can help you with your pool or spa issue. As we recently passed 1,000 and we are close to 2,000 subscribers on YouTube, I wanted to take a moment to thank each and every one of you for your support. Your likes, comments, and sales truly mean the world to me. It motivates me to keep creating valuable content to help as many people as possible solve and prevent pool leaks. If you want to learn more about me and my work, please find me on social media such as Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn, or visit our website for more information. But enough about me. Let's talk about the pressure test process. Firstly, let's break down why and how we pressure test the pool or spa pipes. Why do we pressure test the pipes? The reason we will perform a pressure test on the pipelines is to verify that there is no opening on the pipes or on the fittings of the lines. This opening can cause another leak if it's above the water level, for example, on the fittings of a suction line, and affect the water flow, or below the pool water level and it can cause a severe water loss. One side note I would like to make here is that the pressure test should be your last test, and you shouldn't just start pressure testing lines before you perform hepatic pressure or at least eliminate other options or possible leaks, meaning that you have verified that the leak is somewhere along the lines and found nothing on the rest of the components of the pool or spa. Another reason we pressure test the lines with water and air combined is to pinpoint the exact location of an underground leak with the help of ultrasound equipment. If you would like to learn more about what an underground leak sounds like, check out our video that we'll find on the description below. In order to pressure test the pipeline, you have to apply pressure with air or water from one end of the line and see the other end with a proper pressure plug or valve. If the line holds pressure for at least 10 minutes, then the line is good and leak free. If the pressure drops, you have to check all your connections and fittings and test them again. If it keeps dropping and all your connections and fittings are sealed properly, then the line has a leak. Unfortunately, there are no pressure testing standards in the pool industry, and with some research you will find out that every company uses a different amount of pressure and time for their test. Many leak detectors will say that a proper pressure on the PVC pool or spa lines is between 10 to 25 psi for 1.5 to 2 inches pipes, and 5 to 15 psi for larger lines than 2 inches. From my training and experience, I would say that between 15 and 20 psi is a safe and reliable pressure for a leak detection on 1.5 and 2 inches pipes, and 5 to 15 psi for larger pipes. As for the duration of a pressure test, opinions vary as well among pool companies. I would say, from my experience of pressure testing hundreds of pools and spas, that you will observe even a small leak on the lines within 3 to 5 minutes. Although if the pressure doesn't drop for the first 5 minutes, I would recommend you to keep pressure testing for at least 10 to 20 minutes, especially if you're using water. Water doesn't compress as air does, and sometimes depending on the size and location of the opening, it takes longer time to observe the drop on the gauge, and you will definitely do not want to get the wrong results. Every time you perform a pressure test, you have to take some basic precautions and inform anyone that is close to the testing area to not stand over or close to the plugs or your pressure rig. Because we are dealing with high pressure, there is a danger of plugs being removed from the lines with force, and that can cause serious damage if it comes in contact with a person. Do not stand over the plugs or remove them when the lines are under pressure. The safety first, by knowing the danger and repercussions of a pressure test. Now that we know why we pressure test the lines, the danger, and the technicalities, let's break down the steps of the pressure test. Before you start pressure testing any pipeline, you have first to figure out where the line begins from the plumbing equipment and where it ends into the pool. Also, you have to know if the line or lines are connected with other lines. For example, if a pool has two return outlets but only one pipe is connected with a filter or heater, then this line has a T somewhere along the lines and it splits in two. In this case, you have one end of the line at the pool equipment side and two other ends into the pool. Another example and really important for suction lines are the following. If a pool has one schema line and a main drain, but only one suction line is connected with the pump, then the main drain and schema line is connected together. In this situation, you have to dive and plug the main drain in order to pressure test both suction lines at the same time. If you are dealing with more complicated lines and connections, you can simply apply pressure with air on one of the suspect lines, preferably from the equipment side, and observe the bubbles that are coming into the pool. Then turn off the pressure, plug the lines that you saw the bubbles coming out of, and try again with a lower pressure. Repeat the process until all the connected lines are plugged in. After you find out which lines are connected or not, you have to decide which end you will plug and which end you will apply the pressure. There is no rule on where you should apply the pressure. That would depend on the setup of the pool outlets and pipe fittings on the equipment. Sometimes you might have to cut the lines in order to properly pressure test and reconnect them after the test. For that reason, we should always have available couplings, primer, and high-quality PVC glue. If you can't set up your pressure test gear on the equipment end because the plumbing is old or there is not enough space to set it up, you will pressure test the line from the pool side and you will plug the line at the equipment side. Whatever you decide to apply the pressure, you have to make sure that all your plugs and fittings are sealed properly. If the plumbing equipment is relatively new and the diverter valves are new as well, you might be able to close the line by turning the valve and applying pressure at the pool side. Although most of the time, those valves are not sealing 100% and allowing water or air to escape through the valve. In this case, we should unscrew and remove the cover of the valve carefully, without losing or damaging the O-ring or the screws, and plug the line from the inside. On some of these valves, you might not be able to use the rubber pressure plug since the edge of the port has a curve and they are not rounded. If they are not round, the plug will not be able to hold the pressure. In this case, I will show you the easiest way to plug the lines, but you will need a few tools. First, you will need a 2-inch small size inflatable plug. It can work from 1/2 to 3 inches lines. I will leave the link in the description below for those who are interested in this plug. The next must-have tool I will recommend to you is a cordless high pressure inflator. It really helped me with the pressure test process and made my life easier. Also, you can inflate your vehicle's tire at any time pretty fast. I will add my affiliate link at the description as well. So you will place the closed inflatable plug into the line through the diverter valve and inflate it until the line is sealed. And it's only 2 to 5 seconds of adding pressure into the plug, so you do not have to overdo it. Now that you know which end will add pressure and which end will plug, you will apply the proper pressure and time depending on the size of the line, as we said earlier. If you are dealing with spider tan lines that have air blower lines as well, it is more likely those lines are connected together. Although before you assume anything, you have to test all of them and figure out which lines are connected. If there are upper and lower return sets, it is very common that the upper return lines are connected with the air blower and the lower lever are separate or connected with the pull return lines. For that reason, you have to perform the same technique we said earlier with your air compressor. Apply air pressure on one of the suspect lines at the equipment side if possible and observe on which lines bubbles will come out. If you have to apply the pressure from the spare side, then don't forget to use the valve or plug the line with pressure or inflatable plug on the equipment side. Lastly, you have to close the airline by carefully removing the motor of the air blower and placing your pressure plug. Do not pressure test the return lines without sealing the airlines, because pressure can pop up the motor of the line. And yes, I'm not perfect and I did learn from my mistakes. That's why I'm sharing my experience, so you don't have to repeat the same errors. Now, let's see some examples of what could possibly go wrong with the test. The first and most important mistake is adding into the line high pressure in a very short time. Meaning that when you apply pressure on any line, you have to insert the air or water slowly. If you apply high pressure in a very short time of a few seconds, the plug or plugs that are sealing the other end of the line will blow out of the pipe with force and can cause an accident or damage the lines. Take your time and introduce air or water slowly. Start at 5 pounds and if it holds the pressure for the first 10 seconds, increase it to 10 pounds. Wait for another 10 seconds and increase it to 15, and if it's possible, to 20 and 25. I say if possible because sometimes larger than 2 inches plugs have a hard time to holding the amount of pressure for too long. So according to the size of the pipe, apply the right pressure. The next common mistake is when the pressure drops and you assume right away that you have a leak on the lines. If the pressure drops, the first thing you have to do is to check all your fittings and connections and repeat the process before you conclude anything. Sometimes tiny openings on your setup can give you false results. For that reason, I recommend a pressure test with air, because you can observe the bubbles in the water if there is an air leak on your equipment. Also, you can use water with soap and spray all the connections on the line that is under pressure and make sure there is no opening. If you see bubbles on the connections, you have to cut the lines in order to pressure test properly if you cannot seal it. If the line that you are pressure testing has a check or diverter valve and the air is escaping through the cover or the screws, You have to remove the cover and plug it in with a proper pressure plug. After you verify that all the ends and fittings are sealed, repeat the test again. Lastly, if the pressure holds, you have to release the pressure slowly and not remove the plugs when the line is under pressure. As we said, safety first. At this point, I would like to ask you, what is the biggest struggle performing a pressure test? Feel free to share your experience and concerns about this process. Your feedback is always welcome. Now, let's recap the steps of the pressure test. First, you have to eliminate the option of a leak on all the other components of the pool or spa before you start pressure testing. Make sure that you check on the components of the pools, like main drain, pool lights, the connectors of the skimmer bags, the steps if it's a liner pool. Make sure that you check everything and you resolve that you have a leak in your lines. Figure out how many lines are connected together. Find all the ends of the suspect lines. How many outlets are on the pool end or the spa? Is it multiple outlets on the pool and only one pipe on the pool equipment, or multiple ones? Decide in which end you will apply the pressure and which end you will place the plugs. Apply pressure between 15 to 25 pounds for 1.5 to 2 inches pipes, and between 5 and 50 pounds for larger than 2 inches pipes. And most important, remember that during the pressure test process, you have to be extra careful and don't let anyone stand over the plugs or your pressure rod. Remember, safety first. If pressure drops, check all your fittings and connections and repeat the process at least 3 times. Make sure that everything is sealed when you're getting the right results. Eighth, if the pressure holds, keep it for at least 10 to 20 minutes, and if it doesn't drop, you release the pressure very slowly. If there is a leak on the lines and you need to pinpoint the exact location of it, you have to use more sophisticated equipment. If you want me to make a video on how to find an underground leak, or if you have another suggestion for a video related to a pool leak, please let me know in the comment section. Meanwhile, I recommend you to watch my underground water leak detection video to take a peek how I managed to find underground leaks. If you find this video valuable, the only thing I ask in return is to share it with people that may benefit from it. My mission is to help as many people as possible with their pool leak challenge. Please also hit the like button if you liked my video, and subscribe if you haven't so far, and I will make sure to create as much valuable content as possible. For now, thank you so much for watching, stay safe and take care.